Come, come, Mr. Adams. If you have grievances, and I'm sure you have, our present system must provide a gentler means of redressing them, short of revolution. Yes, that's what he wants. Nothing less will satisfy him. Violence, rebellion, treason. Now, Mr. Adams, are these the acts of Englishmen?
Not Englishmen, Dickinson. Americans.
No, sir, Englishmen!
Please, Mr. Dickinson, must you start banging? How's a man to sleep?
Forgive me, Dr. Franklin, but must you start speaking? How is a man to stay awake? We'll promise to be quiet, sir. I'm sure everyone prefers that you remain asleep.
If I'm to hear myself called an Englishman, sir, I assure you I prefer I'd remain asleep.
Oh, now, what's so terrible about being called an Englishman? The English don't seem to mind.
Nor would I, were I given the full rights of an Englishman. But to call me one without those rights is like calling an ox a bull. He's thankful for the honor, but he much rather have restored what's rightfully his.
When did you first notice they were missing, sir? Fortunately, the people of these colonies maintain a higher regard for their mother country.
Higher, certainly, than she feels for them. Never was such a valuable possession so stupidly and so recklessly managed than this entire continent by the British Crown. Our industry discouraged, our resources pillaged. Worst of all, our very character stifled. We've spawned a new race here, Mr. Dickinson. Rougher, simpler, more violent, more enterprising, less refined. We're a new nationality. We require a new nation.
Well, that may be your opinion, Dr. Franklin, but as I said, the people feel quite differently.
Now, what do you know about the people, Dickinson? You don't speak for the people. You represent only yourself. And that precious status quo you keep imploring the people to preserve for their own good is nothing more than the eternal preservation of your own property.
Mr. Adams, you have an annoying talent for making such delightful words as property sound quite distasteful. In heaven's name, what's wrong with property? Perhaps you've forgotten that many of us first came to these shores in order to secure rights to property, and that we hold these rights no less dear than the rights you speak of.
Yes, so safe, so fat, so comfortable in Pennsylvania.
And what is this independence of yours except the private grievance of Massachusetts? Why is it always Boston that breaks the king's peace? Dear Congress, you must not adopt this evil measure. It is the work of the devil. Leave it where it belongs, in New England.
Brother Dickinson, New England has been fighting the devil for more than 100 years.
And as of now, Brother Sherman, the devil has been winning, hands down.
Why, at this very moment, he's sitting right here in this Congress. Don't let him deceive you. This proposal is entirely his doing.
Oh, it may bear Virginia's name, but it reeks of Adams, Adams, and more Adams.
Look at him, ready to lead this continent down the fiery path of total destruction.
Oh, good God, why can't you acknowledge what already exists? It has been more than a year since Concord and Lexington. Damn it, man, we're at war! Right now!
You may be at war! You, Boston and John Adams!
You and your Pennsylvania proprietors, oh, you cool, considerate men. You hang to the rear on every issue so that if we should go under, you'll still remain afloat!
Are you calling me a coward?
Yes, coward!
Madman?
Landlord?
Lawyer?
Is the Congress. Stop it, I say. The enemy's out there.
No, Mr. Rodney, the enemy is here.
No, I say he's out there. England. England closing in, cutting off our air. There's no time. No air.
Dr. Hall, cancer.
But he should go home.
A man should die in his own bed. John. John Adam.
I'm here, Caesar.
I leave you a divided Delaware. Forgive me.
I'll take you home, Caesar.